Conclusion: Become your own patron. Failure has a function. It asks you if you really want to go on making things. Elizabeth Gilbert, Big Magic. Well, before becoming an author, or even an adult, I spent years studying esoteric histories. I was fascinated by astrology and astronomy, tarot and crystal balls, and Jungian arguments and hero's journey theories. People often describe me as a laid-back, light-hearted kid, but internally I was, and still am, fascinated by the shadow, parts that we don't know of ourselves. As a late teen, the complete Jung and the classical mythology textbook were regular comfort reading. In one nonfiction book, I read about highly spiritual monks investigating potentially dangerous religious areas. It may have been a temple thought cursed by a dark entity, or a church that needed to be blessed by a grounded, focused force like themselves. The monks, however possible, never go it alone, though. Instead, one brave monk leads the group into the dangerous area. The other members begin tying a rope tightly around the waist of the leader and then, ever so carefully, clinching their hands around the lagging rope and bracing themselves as the leader opened the door. They remain outside as the brave monk goes inside. The theory is this: if things get out of hand, then the group pulls the lead monk back to safety. He had an out, and the monk felt more free to explore, as he knew he could be pulled out of a jam. He relaxed. From my reading, this is why certain monk sects to this day still wear frayed ropes around their cloth. It's not just practical to keep their loincloth intact, but a subtle reminder that they are always protected by the group. They are never lost. They are alone, but never abandoned. As I'm finishing this book on New Year's Eve 2018, I feel the weight, not the levity, of my progress. The pieces don't feel like they're coming together, or more accurately, the parts are not coming together as quickly as I want or need them to be. It is one thing to not be sure what needs to be done. It is quite another to not be sure if you have the capacity to make the journey. It is in these moments you have to become your own energy source. No one cares about your particular mission, desire, or impact as much as you do. Recently, an entrepreneur confessed her frustration not finding employees as passionate as she was about her business. She will probably always be frustrated, as she will never find someone as passionate as she is. Otherwise, they'd be starting their own business. Your mama, your partner, and your advocates hopefully have your back. You need to man the front. Moments like my New Year's Eve will always happen to you. They remind you that you are the ancient monk in your new, dangerous, highly spiritual place, and you are alone. You are always alone. Your safety rope is your own awareness. Sometimes others won't treat you at your true worth, often because they are holding more financial or veto power and abusing the imbalance. You need to build great partnerships, not just based on the needs, the money, or of the ego, but on how positively you feel working with the other. That positive feeling will naturally create creative, emotional, and potentially financial prosperity. Everything starts with a feeling. The energy from the feeling opens up the new opportunities. Sometimes the ends will not meet. The resources you get from a beautifully done endeavor may be a great contact for future ideas, a cool story to tell people later, or a brilliant vision of what could be next for you. In the meantime, get your bread. There is no shame in that. I love Elizabeth Gilbert's take, in Big Magic, about keeping a day job for years after becoming a professional writer, saying, "I was always willing to work hard so my creativity could play lightly, and in doing so, I became my own patron." And sometimes the world won't seem to see your purpose. The worst way to create is to say that you want your thing to be embraced by the world. It is too earnest. You open the door to grandstanding and preaching. And what if your thing isn't embraced by the world? The bitterness will leach from your skin, and others will probably sense your resistance even before you give them the thing, as they recognize it in you when you share your idea and they don't have an immediately positive reaction. Instead of being embraced by the world, how do you want to transform one person? Literally, just one. Make the goal of serving one, and when you do make an impact, your appreciation will shine and nourish when you have those dark, cold nights. All successes are based on quantum leaps, be it having a fabulous business partnership, a highly profitable business, or a true appreciation by the world. It isn't there, then it is. You don't know when the switch will flip. As Deepak Chopra says, when and where will bubbles appear in a pot of boiling water? It is binary and sudden and unpredictable. We know it will happen, though, provided we keep the pot on a consistent source. Understanding your creative power, value, and service is your consistent source, your monk's rope, your allies on this journey. It is the Ouroboros, the mythical snake eating its own tail. It is nourished forever. Imagine never retiring, not because you need to work to live, but because you live to work. You live to serve. You feed it, and it feeds you. Forever. Your job, then, isn't to predict the leap to success, nor to wait for success before you begin. Your job is to serve, and in serving, your true worth will always come to you. It begins when you bring your worth to the table. It begins with you.